فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
ولذلك ابن القيم has actually summarized this issue. So there's no need for me to explain it to you from my own self. There's a kitab written by Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah is called At-Turuq al-Hukmiyyah fi al-Siyasah al-Shar'iyyah. Ibn Qayyim talks about something very powerful. Are you with me, brothers? And that is, when the Prophet alayhi salatu wassalam spoke about the deviated groups, how many groups did he say are deviated, that are going to go into the hellfire? 70. And how much is going to go to the paradise, Jannah? 1. Some people opposed this hadith with their logic. And what they said was, then this hadith goes against the other large amount of hadith that say that this ummah, sawadul a'zam, is the largest quantity and large number, and they are large in number. And you're saying that only one group is going to go to Jannah? What about all these hadith that are saying that the Prophet ﷺ, the Day of Judgment, is going to see his ummah, and his whole ummah is going to close off the horizon, and it's large in number like this? How do you reconcile between it? Ibn al-Qayyim answers that question in a very scholarly manner. And he says the following. He says that the people are of types when it comes to the innovators. The first type are al-jahil al-muqallid. He's ignorant and he's a blind follower. الَّذِي لَا بَصِيرَةَ لَهُ. He has no insight. There's no knowledge. فَهَذَا لَا يُكَفَّرْ وَلَا يُفَسَّقْ وَلَا تُرَدُّ شَهَادَتُهُ. This one, takfir is not done to him. And he's not considered as a fasiq. So the mubtadi' would be in there as well. He would not be labeled as a fasiq. Look what he adds on to that. وَلَا تُرَدُّ شَهَادَتُهُ. And his testimony is not rejected. Look what he adds on to that. He says, إِذَا لَمْ يَكُنْ قَادِرًا عَلَى تَعَلُّمِ الْهُدَى. As long as he's not able to learn guidance. If he's able to learn guidance, it's going to take us to the second point, inshallah ta'ala. Are you with me? We're talking about a person who is upon misguidance. He's a mubtadi'. Are you with me? Meaning he's doing bid'ah. Let's leave the word mubtadi' for here for now. But he's doing bid'ah. This individual, he's a jahil. And he's doing taqleed of somebody, a shaykh he looks up to. He has no insight. This one, we don't label him as a kafir, nor do we label him as a fasiq, and his testimony in the court, Islamic court, is accepted. And his rule, but he says with the condition, that he's إِذَا لَمْ يَكُنْ قَادِرًا عَلَى تَعَلِّمُ الْهُدَى, that he is not able to learn guidance. If he's able, so this person is unable to learn guidance. There's no other ideology in that land except this batil. He's in a village where the only belief that's there is the bid'ah. And he's the sheikhs, the people who he looks up to, the shuyukh, are propagating this. So he takes it on board. Ibn al-Qayyim says, وَحُكْمُهُ حُكْمُ الْمُسْتَضْعَفِينَ مِنَ الرِّجَالِ وَالنِّسَاءِ وَالْوِلْدَانِ الَّذِينَ لَا يَسْتَطِيعُونَ حِيلَةً وَلَا يَهْتَدُونَ سَبِيلًا. He's like the ruling of the what? He takes the ruling of that mustab'afin. Where the mustab'afin? The Muslims who are unable to migrate from the Muslim lands. They're weak. Okay? Like the women and the children and stuff. He says, فَأُولَٰئِكَ عَسَى اللَّهُ أَن يَعْفُوَ عَنْهُمْ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَفُوًا غَفُورًا. Those ones, Allah is going to probably forgive them, inshaAllah ta'ala. مُقَجَاهِد, مُقَلِّد. And he's unable to learn the guidance. There's no alternative. This is the only ideology in that village. The second one is, المتمكن. The one who is able, min as-su'ali. Mutamakkin here means what? It means able. It means able. Of what? Min as-su'ali, in asking. He's able to go out there and ask questions. Wa talab al-hidayah, meaning there are mashayikh, there are ulama, there's masajid that propagate the sunnah in his local area. There are people who he can go to and ask the question. He's able to. Wa ma'rifat al-haq. And he's able to go out and learn the truth. Wa lakin yatruku dhalik. But he leaves off all of that. اشتغالاً بدنياه. He leaves it for worldly reasons. He's busy. He's into business and money and wants to make that. ورئاسته ولذاته ومعاشه وغير ذلك. فهذا مفرض مستحق للوعيد. This one, he is extreme in negligence. He's placed and deserves استحقاق الوعيد. He deserves punishment. He deserves Allah to punish him. آثم بترك ما وجب عليه من تقوى الله بحسب استطاعته. He left off that which was obligatory of, on him in terms of having taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَهَذَا حُكْمُ حُكْمُ أَمْثَالِ مِنْ تَارِكِ بَعْضِ الْوَاجِبَاتِ. And his ruling is like the ruling of those Muslims who leave off things which are obligatory on them. The sister that stops wearing hijab, the brother that cuts his beard, and the likes of that. He takes the ruling of those ones. فَإِذَا غَلَبَ مَا فِيهِ مِنَ الْبِدْعَةِ وَالْهَوَىٰ. If the innovation and the desires that is in him becomes high and it grows bigger, عَلَى مَا فِيهِ مِنَ السُنَّةِ, it becomes more than the sunnah that is in him and the guidance, رُدَّتْ شَهَادَتُهُ, his testimony is rejected. وَإِنْ غَلَبَ مَا فِيهِ مِنَ السُنَّةِ. But if he has more sunnah with him and he has more guidance with him, قُبِلَتْ شَهَادَتُهُ, his testimony is accepted. They'll accept his testimony. Number three, أن يسأل ويطلب ويطلب. The second one is أن يسأل ويطلب ويتبين له الهدى ويتركه. The third one is he asks, he goes on the quest of learning guidance. The guidance becomes clear to him, but then he leaves it. After having known it, after having received the knowledge, after having gained guidance, he leaves it off. Why? تقليداً وتعصباً أو بغضاً أو معاداتاً لأصحابه. He leaves this off out of blind following and fanaticism. أو بغضاً, or hate he has for that particular individuals. أو معاداتاً لأصحابه. He has hate, معاداتاً لأصحابه. He hates the people who are calling to this message. You see? And he knows the truth is with them. It became clear to him. فَهَذَا أَقَلُّ دَرَجَّةِ أَنْ يَكُونَ فَاسِقًا. This one, the minimum that can be said about him, the minimum is that he's a fasiq. وَتَكْفِيرُ مَحَلُّ اجْتِهَادٍ. To place takfir on him is a discussion that's open. It's an ijtihadi related issue. This person, وَتَفْصِيلُ. Scholars are actually discussing, is this person a Muslim or a kafir? فَإِنْ كَانَ مُعْلَنًا دَاعِيًا. If he, what he's doing is propagating it out in the open and he's out there calling to it, رُدَّتْ شَهَادَتُهُ, his testimony is rejected. وَفَتَاوِيهِ, and his verdict. وَأَحْكَامُهُ, and his rulings. نعم. Those are the three people Shaykh al-Islam, Al-Allamah, Al-Muhaqqiq, Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyyah mentions. Also, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said something very powerful. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said something very powerful. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he says, we're going to go back to Ibn al-Qayyim's speech regarding the question that we put in the beginning, don't worry, about the hadith of the hadith al-iftiraq. We'll go back to that, don't worry. And this, by the way, is going to be the last qa'idah on this book anyways. He brings it as the last qa'idah on this issue of the hadith al-iftiraq and this issue. But Ibn Taymiyyah says in his kitab, دَرْءُ تَعَارُضُ الْعَقْلِ وَالنَّقْلِ. A lot of people say to you, أخي, فلان is jahil, يا أخي. He's jahil. How can he be mubtadi'? He's jahil. Listen to what Ibn Taymiyyah, says. Ibn Taymiyyah says, وَأَمَّا أَهْلُ الْبِدْعَةِ الْمُخَالِفِ الْمُخَالَفِ الْمُخَالِفَةِ لِلْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ. As for the أهل البدع, who are in opposition to the kitab and the sunnah, for whom they are, إِمَّا فِي الْجَهْلِ الْبَصِيطِ. Either their ignorance is jahl, which is basir, simple ignorance. وَإِمَّا فِي الْجَهْلِ الْمُرَكَّبِ. Or their jahl is compounded ignorance. So don't tell us that a mubtadi' can't be jahil. Rather, a mubtadi' is between either jahl basir or jahl murakkab. What else is it? Sahih? Are you with me? And then he brings evidences for that. He brings قوله تعالى كظلمات في بحر اللجي يغشاه موج من فوقه موج من فوقه سحاب ظلمات بعضها فوق بعض إذا أخرج يده لم يكد يراها ومن لم يجعل الله له نورا فما له من نور. Anyone who Allah hasn't made light for them, there's no, what's the light that's being spoken about here? Meaning he has no knowledge. He hasn't got the guidance, he hasn't got the understanding. So he's upon darknesses, he's upon the ignorance. Ignorance is the darkness here. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, كسراب بقيعة يحسبه الظمآن ماء حتى إذا جاءه لم يجده شيئا ووجد الله عنده فوفاه حسابه والله سريع الحساب. And then he goes on to say, فأهل الجهل والكفر البسيط لا يعرفون الحق ولا ينصرونه. They don't know the truth and they don't give victory to it. The ones who have what? The people of ignorance are kufr. Whose jahal is jahal basir, simple ignorance. They don't know the truth, so and they don't give victory to it. Wa ahlul jahl wal kufr al murakkab, those whose ignorance is ignorance which is compounded. يعتقدون أنهم عرفوا وعلموا. They believe that they recognize and they know. والذي معهم ليس بعلم بل جهل. But what is with them is not knowledge. They think they know, but what is with them is not knowledge. It's actually ignorance. They perceive the matter in a wrong way. But I want to ask you a question. مع ذلك did Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah take away from them the Ahlul Bid'ah? No. Did he strip away from them that they're kuffar? No. No. Your neighbor who doesn't pray, who tells you I'm a disbeliever, is, and you ask them about Islam and they say to you, yeah, I've never read about Islam. Yeah, I mean, I've heard things here and there. Muhammad is a prophet, right? Yeah, yeah, I've heard that. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Are you going to say, no, you're not a kafir because you're jahil? I'm asking you a question. Are you going to say that? No, you're not going to say that. You're not going to say that. You're not going to say that. Because the jahil here is jahil basit. It's not jahil murakkab. They will say to you, I don't know about Islam. I've never read about it really, to be honest. I don't even hate Islam. I just don't know anything about it. That still doesn't take away from them that they're disbelievers. They're still disbelievers. Ibn al-Qayyim then speaks about the issue that I brought up, which was what, brothers? That, how is it that you reconcile between hadith al-iftiraq, the hadith where the Prophet ﷺ mentioned 72 are going to be in the hellfire and one is going to be in paradise. How do you reconcile between that? And that the over what the Muslims are the largest number, the narrations that have come, that the Muslims are what? That they are the majority of the people in paradise. أكثر أهل الجنة are who? هذه الأمة, right? This ummah is the most in Jannah. ليس كذلك? Are they not? How do you reconcile between that and the hadith of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام where he said that the deviated group is one? Sorry, the guided group is only one. And the ones that are going to be in paradise are only one. How do you reconcile between? How do you reconcile between the two? The way that you reconcile between the two is that Ibn Taymiyyah says the groups, the ones who are going to be in the hellfire are the ones who have knowledge and it has become clear to them. This matter has become clear to them. Are you with me? They have ilm, they have understanding and comprehension. The truth has been made clear to them. But they left off the truth, taqleedan wa ta'assuban. They left it out of blind following, out of being fanatic towards a particular individual, or hating the people who are propagating it. Are you with me? The other groups, on the other hand, which are ignorant, the truth hasn't come to them, they are not going to enter that. Are you with me? They're not going to enter that. And the names are more, 73 groups. Who said that the number of those who are in the groups are necessarily going to be not more than the people who are going to be saved? The hadith didn't mention that. Whether it is or whether it's not, affirming it and negating it, the narration didn't speak about that. It just spoke about there are 73 groups. 72 of those are in the hellfire, and only one group is going to be in Jannah. The hadith didn't mention that the one group, in terms of number, if it's equal or more than the 70, because within the 72, the people who are being spoken about are the people of knowledge who chose to go against the truth. Are you with me? And the people who are saved are the people of knowledge. The group that is saved are the people of knowledge. And the ammatun nas, the general mass, who are unaware of the truth, which hasn't become clear to them. The man who just comes to the masjid, he prays. He doesn't know anything. He's upon the fitrah to salima. Are you with me, brothers? That individual is also, Shaykh Ibn al-Qayyim mentions it and explains it like that. And don't worry, we will come back to it, inshallah ta'ala, when we deal with the sharah of the last qa'idah. القاعدة الرابعة وثلاثون. The 34th قاعدة. The 34th قاعدة. أن ضرر أهل البدع رحمك قبو جوريدك أن ضرر أهل البدع the harm that the innovators have on the Muslims can be greater قد يكون أعظم من ضرر الكفار it could be greater than the harm that the disbelievers put the Muslims through pay attention to this أن ضرر أهل البدع the harm of the innovators the harm of the harm that the innovators cause the Muslims can be greater than the harm that the disbelievers put the Muslims through and we spoke about that before in the previous one so we spoke about that one previously but there are two ayahs that the Shaykh rahimahullah and the Shaykh hafidhahullah brought and that is the ones who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about them وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يُعْجِبُكَ قَوْلُهُ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَيُشْهِدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا فِي قَلْبِهِ وَهُوَ أَلَدُّ الْخِصَامِ Allah also says لَوْ خَرَجُوا فِيكُمْ مَا زَادُوكُمْ إِلَّا خَبَالًا وَلَأَوْضَعُوا خِلَالَكُمْ يَبْغُونَكُمُ الْفِتْنَةِ وَفِيكُمْ سَمَّاعُونَ لَهُمْ وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِالظَّالِمِينَ Allah says, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ from the people are those مَنْ يُعْجِبُكَ قَوْلُهُ a people who state, whose their statements amaze you. Wow, Allah is meant to speak. MashaAllah. Eloquent. His speech amazes you. فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا in this world. وَيُشْهِدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا فِي قَلْبِهِ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala testifies and knows what's in their hearts. وَهُوَ أَلَدُّ الْخِصَامِ He's a very argumentative person. وَإِذَا تَوَلَّى سَعَى فِي الْأَرْضِ لِيُفْسِدَ فِيهَا وَيُهْلِكَ الْحَرْثَ وَالنَّسْلَ When he turns around, he brings corruption to this earth. He brings instability to the land. تَوَلَّى فِي الْأَرْضِ لِيُهْلِكَ وَإِذَا تَوَلَّى سَعَى فِي الْأَرْضِ لِيُهْلِكَ فِيهَا وَإِذَا تَوَلَّى سَعَى فِي الْأَرْضِ لِيُهْلِكَ فِيهَا يُفْسِدُ وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يُعْجِبُكَ قَوْلُهُ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَيُشْهِدُ اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا فِي قَلْبِهِ وَهُوَ أَلَدُّ الْخِصَامِ وَإِذَا تَوَلَّى سَعَى فِي الْأَرْضِ لِيُفْسِدَ فِيهَا وَيُهْلِكَ الْحَرْثَ وَالنَّسْلَ وَاللَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْفَسَادَ اللَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْكَرَبْشَنَ وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُ اتَّقِ اللَّهَ When he said to him, fear Allah, أخذته العزة بالإثم فحسبه جهنم ولبئس المهاد When he said to him, fear Allah, what are you doing? Why are you doing this for? Fear Allah, stop what you're doing. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُ اتَّقِ اللَّهِ يَا أَخِي what you're doing is wrong. Fear Allah. What happens? أَخَذَتُ الْعِزَّةُ بِالْإِثْمِ He gets arrogant. How dare you say to me, fear Allah? Who do you think you are? I've been studying for this much years. I'm a person who learned. Or he will say to you, he will style it out nicely. He will say, don't worry. I'm experienced now, alhamdulillah. I've grown out of that. They're just little immature people, inshallah ta'ala. That's the same thing. Just different wordings. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُ اتَّقِ اللَّهَ أَخَذَتُ الْعِزَّةُ بِالْإِثْمِ فَحَسْبُهُ جَهَنَّمُ وَلَبِئْسَ الْمِهَادُ All you could just do is say, nah, it's wrong what I did. And I repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these people, their statements amaze you. Because they're with you guys. They can trick you guys. They're amongst you. They like you. They have a lot of similarities with you. And the person who is similar to you can always fool you. Also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَوْ خَرَجُوا فِيكُمْ مَا زَادُوكُمْ إِلَّا خَبَالًا وَلَأَوْضَعُوا خِلَالَكُمْ يَبْغُونَكُمُ الْفِتْنَةَ وَفِيكُمْ سَمَّاعُونَ لَكُمْ Allah says, وَفِيكُمْ سَمَّاعُونَ لَهُمْ وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِالظَّالِمِينَ Allah tells us in this verse that when they go out with you, O Muhammad, in the battle, and they spend time with you, the thing that they do is that they are with you in the battle, and all they work towards is weakening you in the battle. They want to take the army away from you. They want to misguide the people. And they may even what? They may even just listen to your plans. That's what they want to do, yeah? Okay. Let's go to the kuffar and tell them what Muhammad wants to do. And Ahlul Bid'ah are like that. Ahlul Bid'ah are the ones who always show the kuffar the weaknesses of the Muslims. Are you with me? When the kuffar come to you today, are you there? When the kuffar come to you today and they want to refute the Quran and its preservation, who are they going to use? They could use the Rafidah. They're going to say the Rafidah said the Quran is not preserved. and there are Muslims like you. So you Muslims don't all believe that the Quran is preserved, do you? Who opened that door? Who made that a discussion that could be had? A mubtadi' dal, an innovator opens that argument, opens that door. They're the ones who bring the enemies in, who show the Muslims weaknesses. So they are great enemies. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah says something very powerful in Kitab al-Fatawa al-Kubra. He says about the Mubtadi'ah and their harm towards Islam and the Muslims. He says, وَلِهَذَا كَثِيرًا مَا يَكُونُ أَهْلُ الْبِدَعِ مَعَ الْقُدْرَةِ يُشْبِهُونَ الْكُفَّارَ فِي اسْتِحْلَالِ قَتْلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَتَكْفِيرِهِمْ. Ibn Taymiyyah said, and a lot do Ahlul Bid'ah, when they get the ability, they imitate the kuffar. What do? They permit for themselves the killing of the Muslims. Look at what ISIS did to the Muslims. Who did they kill? Many innocent women and children, Muslims, right? Did they not? They killed them. This is something that the kuffar do to the Muslims. But the people thought that these people were Muslims like them. Are you with me? They thought they were Muslims like them. Look at the harm that they brought to them. كَمَا يَفْعَلُهُ الْخَوَارِجُ وَالْمُعْتَزِلَةُ وَالْجَهْمِيَةُ وَفُرُوعِهِمْ. Each group, other than Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, wallahi when they get control over you, wallahi when they get the upper hand over you, the first thing they want to do is eradicate you and get rid of you. That's what they work towards. That's what they work towards. As for Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, when they take over, as Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah says, وَلِهَذَا كَانَ أَهْلُ السُنَّةِ مَعَ أَهْلِ الْبِدَعِ بِالْعَكْسِ إِذَا قَدِرُوا عَلَيْهِمْ لَمْ يَعْتَدُونَ لَا يَعْتَدُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِالتَّكْفِيرِ وَالْقَتْلِ وَغَيْرِ ذَلِكَ. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, when they get control over the innovators, they don't kill them. Nor do they label them as kuffar. Nor do they make their blood permissible for them. بَلْ يَسْتَعْمِلُونَ مَعْهُمُ الْعَدْلِ الَّذِي أَمَرَ اللَّهُ بِهِ. Rather, what they used with the innovators is justice, in which Allah commanded them to come with. Are you with me? That's how they are. Ahlul Sunnah al-Jama'ah always balanced. Because what they are referring back to, what they are picking up from is the Qur'an and the Sunnah. Whereas the Mubtadi' is picking up from his desires. So if his desires tells him to get rid of you, he'll get rid of you. If his desires tells him to leave you, he will leave you. It just depends on how he feels that day. القاعدة الخامسة والثلاثون. The 35th قاعدة. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah warn the Muslims from reading the books that consist of innovation. They don't allow them to read books that have innovation in it. قال الله تعالى, Allah said in the Quran, وَإِنَّ مِنْهُمْ لَفَرِيقًا يَلْوُونَ أَلْسِنَتَهُمْ بِالْكِتَابِ لِتَحْسَبُوهُ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَمَا هُوَ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَيَقُولُونَ هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ وَمَا هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ وَمَا هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ وَيَقُولُونَ عَلَى اللَّهِ الْكَذِبَ وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. وقال سبحانه, Allah also says, يَا أَيُّهَا الرَّسُولُ لَا يَحْزُنكَ الَّذِينَ يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْكُفْرِ مِنَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا آمَنَّا بِأَفْوَاهِهِمْ وَلَمْ تُؤْمِنْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَمِنَ الَّذِينَ هَادُوا سَمَّاعُونَ لِلْكَذِبِ سَمَّاعُونَ لِقَوْمٍ آخَرِينَ لَمْ يَأْتُوكَ يحرفون الكلمة من بعد مواضعه يقولون إن أوتيتم هذا فخذوه وإن لم تؤتوه فاحذروه ومن يرد الله فتنته فلن تملك له من الله شيئا أولئك الذين لم يرد الله أن يطهر قلوبهم لهم في الدنيا خزي ولهم في الآخرة عذاب عظيم. الله says, وَإِنَّ مِنْهُمْ, from amongst them there are a group of people, that will bid'ah. There are amongst them those who write with their own hands in the book, لِتَحْسَبُوهُ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ, so you can think that this is from the book of Allah. What they do is they write books of innovation. They write books of corruption. And they make it look like it's the book of Allah. وَمَا هُوَ مِنَ الْكِتَابِ, it is not from the book of Allah. They change their own books. وَيَقُولُونَ هُوَ مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ, they write their own book. They tamper with the book of Allah. They change and they alter it. And then they sell it and they pass it on to you guys as though it's the book of Allah. Ahlul Bid'ah do that today. They write a book and they say to you, this book is a book of guidance. This is the book that will bring you to the straight path. This is the book that will save you from any deviation and misconception and whatnot. When in reality is what? It's a book that consists of misguidance and corruption. That's what it is. So it's like the books of the Munafiqeen or the Yahud and the Nasara, what they authored. ولذلك شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية was asked عن جندي له أقطار ونسخ بيده صحيح المسلم وصحيح البخاري والقرآن. شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية was asked about an individual who had actually written صحيح البخاري and صحيح المسلم, and he had actually written the Quran with his own hand. Back in those days, there were not printing companies. Are you with me? The person would actually write the book with their own hand. You wanted Tafsir Ibn Kathir? You wanted Sahih al-Bukhari? You would go to somebody's house and you would say, give me your Sahih al-Bukhari, I will write it. Or there was an individual who would write it for you. He was an asikh, he's a writer. He writes fast. So people go to him and they'll say to him, can you write Sahih al-Bukhari? And he'll sit down and he'll write fast. And he would do that for them. And he has a good handwriting. And he would do it as quick as possible. Are you with me? So Shaykh al-Islam Taymi was asked about an individual who does that, Sahih al-Bukhari, Sahih al-Muslim. Ibn Taymi rahimahullah, when he was asked about this, he said about this situation, and also the same question was put to him, which of the books of tafsir is closest to the book of Allah and the Sunnah? Then Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah responded, and which books are closest to the kitab and which books of tafsir? Would you say that it's a tafsir that is closest to the kitab and the Sunnah? And then Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah responded, and he says, they asked him books, they asked him Zamakhshari's kitab al-Kashaf, Qurtubi's tafsir, al-Baghawi's tafsir and others. And they also asked him about the Kitab Ihya Ulumuddin written by, yeah? The Kitab Ihya Ulumuddin by Abu Hamid al-Ghazali, the Kitab Qutul Qulub, and Kitab al-Mantiq. Books like that, they named to Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. Ibn Taymiyyah said, "Laysa alayhi," there's no harm in this individual who's writing the books of hadith. Are you there? Who keeps saying, because what he does is, this man who writes Sahih Bukhari and Muslim, what he does is that he gets a pen where he buys this pen for a very expensive amount of money. And he sets himself a big dream and he says, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to finish Sahih Bukhari and writing it in 2-3 days, something like that. Is there a sin on this person? And he's using very expensive pen. Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah said, there's no harm in this if he intends from this, in writing the sciences of the Sharia, the Book of Allah and the Hadith which are authentic and blah blah blah. Ibn Taymiyyah speaks about it. Then Ibn Taymiyyah says something very powerful, which is, وَأَمَّا التَّفْسِيرُ, as for the tafsir that are in front of us, which are in front of us, فَأَصَحُّ هَا, the most authentic one is tafsir Muhammad ibn Jarir al-Tabariyyu. It is the most authentic one. And then he says that he mentions in that books the statements of the Salaf, he mentions the Asanid which are Sahiha, and he said, وَلَيْسَ فِيهِ بِدْعَةٌ, there's no innovation in it. وَلَا يَنْقُلُ عَنِ الْمُتَّهِمِينَ, and he doesn't also use, Ibn Jarir al-Tabari doesn't use in his tafsir people who are criticized or who are suspected of, such as Muqatil ibn Sulaiman and Al-Kalbi. He doesn't use those people. And his book is a tafsir al-Ma'thura bil-Asanid, like the books of tafsir of Abdul Razak ibn Hammam al-San'aniyu, and like the tafsir of Abdullah ibn Humayd, and the tafsir of Waqi' ibn Jarrah al-Ruhasi, and Ibn Abi Shayb, and Ahmad ibn Hanbal, and Ishaq ibn Rahuya. These are the books he relied on, Ibn Jarir al-Tabari. He used these people's tafsir. And then he goes and speaks about the tafsir of Baghawi and the tafsir of Ta'alabi, and then he compares all of that. And then he goes towards the tafsir of Zamakhshari. And the topic here we're talking about is warning against the books of what? Innovators, right? Ibn Taymiyyah then speaks about the tafsir of Zamakhshari. He says, وَأَمَّا تَفْسِيرُ الزَّمَخْشَرِي فَالتَفْسِيرُهُ مَشْحُوٌ بِالْبِدْعَةِ. The tafsir of Zamakhshari is filled up with innovation. وَعَلَىٰ طَرِقَةِ الْمُعْتَزِلَةِ, and it is upon the path of the people of Mu'tazila, the Mu'tazila, which is a deviated group. It is the group that beat Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, which is a belief they have, which is inkaru sifat. They reject Allah's characteristics, وَالرُّؤْيَا that Allah will be seen, and they believe that the Quran is created, and they also reject أن الله مريد للكائنات, that Allah intends for His creation, وخالق لأفعال العباد, and they also reject that Allah is the one who created the actions of His slaves. And these are the usul of the Mu'tazila. Akhi, go, she went out. Okay. You see, so Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah warned against the tafsir of Zamakhshari. He warned against the what? The tafsir of Zamakhshari. And this is something that the ulama of the sunnah, qarnan ba'da qarni, they would do. And then Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah spoke about the kitab Qutul Qulub and the kitab Ihya Ulumuddin by Abu Hamid al-Ghazali. The statement, you can go to Majmu' al-Fatawa, the 9th volume, page 269. Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, you fussil, he goes in too much. But what is it that we learn from this chapter? Scholars, they spoke about, are you allowed to buy things that are haram? Are you allowed to buy drugs? Are you allowed to buy harmful things? Are you allowed to buy harmful things? The scholars, they say one of the things that you're not allowed to buy are the books of innovation. They are from the buyu'ul manhiyu anha shara'an. Buying the books of innovation falls under the transactions that are prohibited. It's prohibited. You're not allowed to buy it. They only give an exception to the person who's going to expose this batil, whose job, and he wants, inshallah ta'ala, to bring out to the people, to explain to them that this falsehood is there. But the general mass to go and buy for themselves books of innovation and to study and read it, it is from the buyu', which is harm. If drugs is haram for you to buy because it's going to harm your health, and health is from what? It's from the daruriyatul khams, right? The religion came to protect your sanity, right? So did the religion come to protect your religion, right? It did not come to protect your religion. Huh? It did. It's from the daruriyatul khams. It's from the five things which the religion came to protect, your religion. So you're not allowed to harm your religion by what? By reading these books, philosophy and stuff like that. A person just to go and out and read them. Inshallah ta'ala, today we'll stop there bi'idhnillahi al-kareem. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me, shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.